Hello, fifth graders. How are you? I'm glad to be here with you again. In this time, I'm going to explain you the activities you are going to develop this week. Pay attention to the instructions in order you can understand better what you are going to do. The first instruction is, open your student's book, page number 36. I'm going to explain again. Open your student's book, page number 36. We are going to start with the first activity. And as you can see on this page, you are going to find the main content for this one, and it is tal questions can and can't. Tal questions can and can't. I'm going to explain you this later on. Let's continue with our first activity. The instruction said, read the article and match the information. Read the article and match the information. That is the first activity you are going to develop. Here we have the article. The main content for this article is Life on Lord Howe Island by Luis Porras. Okay, as you can see here, we have the article. This article have, in this case, this article has some questions that you are going to answer, take into account these options that we have in this part. Okay. According to the introduction for this article, it says, Luis Porras interviewed Carney Killer, a resident of Lord Howe Island. Here are her answers to Luis' questions. Pay attention and follow the reading. You can't buy fast food, can you? I'm gonna repeat again. You can't buy fast food, can you? What is the answer for this question? What do you think? What you are gonna do is try to guess one of these options is the correct answer for this question. Okay, we have this one, and the correct answer is letter F. That it says, there aren't any fast food restaurants. There aren't any fast food restaurant. This is the answer for question number one. Here, it means that you are going to write the letter F in this space or in this little box. Okay, boys and girls, I'm going to tell you this in Spanish. Bien, chicos y chicas, lo que tienen que hacer ustedes es leer la pregunta e identificar cuál es la respuesta para cada una de ellas. En este caso, como les he mencionado anteriormente, en este espacio, en este pequeño cuadro, van a escribir la letra de la cual se refiere la respuesta. En este caso, la letra F, esa oración, es la respuesta de esta pregunta. You can buy fast food, can you? And the answer is, there aren't any fast food restaurants. Okay, let's continue with the second question. And we say, you can walk around without shoes, can't you? You can walk around without shoes, can't you? What is the answer for this question? The answer is letter D, this one, letter D. There aren't any poisonous insects or snakes. This is the answer for this question. Means that you are gonna write the letter D here, in this space, letter D. Next, you can swim in the sea, can't you? You can swim in the sea, can't you? What is the answer? The answer is letter C. That says, the water is crystal clear and very clean. Okay, here is the letter C. Okay, very good. Next question. You can't go skateboarding, can you? You can't go skateboarding, can you? What is the answer for this question? That is letter E. This one, letter E. There aren't any skate parks. This is the answer for this. Okay, Here you are gonna write the letter E. Very good. Next, you can see a lot of wildlife, can't you? You can see a lot of wildlife, can't you? What is the answer? Here we have, listen. The letter B. This is the answer, as you can see here. This is the answer for this question. You can see a lot of wildlife, can't you? They say, listen. There are even wild mushrooms that glow in the dark. Okay. And the last one, the last is, people can drive without wearing seatbelts. Can't they? Letter A. But the maximum speed limit is only 25 kilometers per hour. This is the answer for the last question. Letter A. Here. Vaya chicos, en este espacio van a escribir la letra A, que se refiere a la respuesta de la última pregunta. Very good. And I'm going to explain you something about the tag questions using can and can't. I don't know if you remember the previous class in which I explained you the tag questions using a verb be. In this case, tag questions with can and can't. It's the same. As you can see here, we have, you can't buy fast food. Here we have a negative statement. Here, a negative statement. That means that the question is going to be in positive. ¿Qué quiere decir, chicos? Si acá nosotros en la oración tenemos can't, que es en negativo, our tag question, en este caso, aquí vamos a utilizar positivo. Mucho cuidado con eso. Si usted se fija, acá tenemos negativo. Y aquí lo vamos a convertir en positivo. Tenemos otro ejemplo. We have another example here. Acá tenemos la oración positiva. You can walk around without shoes. ¿Verdad? Acá tenemos positiva la oración. Si queremos hacer la tag question, we are gonna use negative. Aquí vamos a escribir can't. Can't you? Okay? I don't know if you understand, but listen, if you don't understand this content, you can write me. Okay? And I'm gonna answer your questions. Okay, boys and girls? This is related with page number 36. Now we are gonna continue with page number 37. Okay, let's continue with page number 37. Here we have another grammatical structure that is related with tag questions with do and don't. It's almost the same as the previous one. Okay, the first activity for this page consists on read the interview and match the questions with the answers. Read the interview and match the questions with the answers. Here we have, okay? My friend Dan lives in an amazing place. My friend Dan lives in an amazing place. Okay? And here we have, listen, here we have the interview. You live on an animal sanctuary with your parents, don't you? What is the correct information related with this? That is what you are going to discover in this moment, okay? You live on an animal sanctuary with your parents, don't you? And here we have the correct, listen, the correct option. Yes, I do. I've lived here all my life. This one. Okay. You are going to match this information, this one, with this one. Okay. Las van a ir cruzando. Van a cruzar líneas con la información. En este caso, esta información va con esta que está acá. Very good. Next. Your animal sanctuary takes in stray and sick. I'm going to repeat again. Here we have your animal sanctuary takes in stray and sick animals, doesn't it? What is the answer? The answer is Listen, what is the answer? Here, okay, this one. This is with this. Very good. Then we have, your mom also works as a vet in the city, doesn't she? Here we have, this one is with this information. No, she doesn't. She used to work in the city. She's here full time now. Okay, and the last one is, you know a lot of animals, don't you? And here we have, well, I live with animals and study them all my life. Okay, this is the correct option. Okay, this one is with this information. Very good. Then we have the second activity for this. Listen and match. I'm gonna play the audio in this moment, and you are gonna try to understand what is the correct information for each of these animals. Okay, pay attention.
Track 23.
Listen.
Listen and match.
Hey, Dan. May I check some animal facts with you?
Sure, Louie. Go ahead.
Bats have extremely sharp hearing, don't they?
Yes, that's right.
Rabbits don't eat meat, do they?
No, they don't. They're vegetarians.
Hamsters hibernate during the winter, don't they?
Yes, they do. They can sleep for months.
Kangaroos carry their babies in a pouch, don't they?
Yes, they do. Wallabies do the same.
Dogs don't sweat, do they?
No, they don't. They don't have any sweat glands. That's why they pant a lot when they're hot.
Snakes lay eggs, don't they?
Yes, they do, but you don't want to eat them for breakfast.
Foxes don't eat grapes, do they?
Actually, gray foxes eat grapes and all kinds of fruit. They can even climb up trees to reach the fruit.
Donkeys don't have waterproof coats, do they?
No, they don't.
Okay, in order you can finish the second activity, I'm gonna share the audio with your tutor in order you can complete it. Okay?